The vertices of a triangle are 1 comma root 3, 2 cos theta comma 2 sin theta, and 2 sin theta comma minus 2 cos theta, where theta belongs to R. Remember, the locus of orthocenter of the triangle is. So let us consider the triangle ABC. The vertices A 1 comma root 3 and B is the point 2 cos theta comma 2 sin theta. And C is the vertex here 2 sin theta comma minus 2 cos theta. And clearly we can see that all these three vertices are equidistant from origin 0 comma 0. Clearly vertices A B and C are equidistant from origin 0 comma 0. So that is OA is equal to under root of 1 plus root 3 whole square 3, that is equal to root 4, which is equal to 2 units. OB is equal to under root of, this is 4 cos square theta plus 4 sin square theta, that is 4 times of cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is equal to root 4, is equal to 2. And OC also equals to root of 4 times of sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is exactly root 4, is equal to 2 units. So we can find that OA is equal to OB is equal to OC, which implies that origin O 0 comma 0 is the circumcenter of triangle ABC. Okay, and now we can find the centroid of the triangle. Centroid of triangle ABC is equal to, so vertex A is 1 comma root 3, so 1 plus 2 cos theta plus 2 sin theta divided by 3, and the next root 3 plus 2 sin theta minus 2 cos theta divided by 3 is a centroid. So let us consider this is your G and this is a circumcenter. Let me mark this as a C instead of O. Let us take circumcenter as C. And since we know O and GC, centroid divides orthocenter and circumcenter in the ratio 2:1. And hence we can find the orthocenter. Let us take orthocenter is some H, K. And the centroid is, this is the centroid point. And the circumcenter is 0 comma 0. So centroid 2 times of origin, 2 times of 0 plus 1 times of h, that is h divided by 3 comma, so 2 times of 0 plus again 1 times of k divided by 3 is equal to the centroid, that is a 1 plus 2 cos theta plus 2 sin theta upon 3 comma root 3 plus 2 sin theta minus 2 cos theta upon 3. So which implies h is equal to 1 plus 2 cos theta plus 2 sin theta, and k is equal to root 3 plus 2 sin theta minus 2 cos theta. So again, this implies here h minus 1 is equal to 2 cos theta plus 2 sin theta, or even if I take 2 common. And here k minus root 3 is equal to 2 times of sin theta minus cos theta. Or this can also be written h minus 1 by 2 is equal to cos theta plus sin theta. And k minus root 3 upon 2 is equal to sin theta minus cos theta. Now make this an equations 1 and 2. Now squaring and adding both the equations. So we can get here h minus 1 by 2 whole square plus k minus root 3 upon 2 whole square is equal to cos square theta plus sin square theta. Here also cos square theta plus, let me write here, cos square plus sin square plus 2 cos theta sin theta. And as for the second equation, sin square theta plus cos square theta minus 2 sin theta cos theta. So if I add this, cos square plus sin square is 1, sin square plus cos square is again 1, and 2 sin theta cos theta minus 2 sin theta cos theta gets cancelled, so we are getting 2. And hence locus of orthocenter h comma k we are taken. Orthocenter h comma k is x minus 1 by 2 whole square plus y minus root 3 upon 2 whole square is equal to 2. So this is answer we can give. So we can go with the option, okay, no options. So we can go with the answer. Or also we can write it as x minus 1 whole square plus y minus root 3 whole square is equal to 2 square is 4, 4 will go other side, 4 to the 8. So this is the answer, right?